Steve-O's our guest on the show, and the show's name is Guest Grumps.
Hey, welcome to Guest Grumps, baby.
Oh, snap. Triumphant return.
Yeah.
If this is the first one that comes out,
this
which
might,
probably will.
We don't know. But hey, fucking either way, we got Steve-O in the house. Steve-O!
Man, it's been a long time in the making, but I finally made it, and I walked in. You asked me what game do I want to play. I asked for the most violent, I mean, not just violent, I wanted just demented,
wrong,
twisted, like upsetting, offensive, like I want the worst of the worst, like whatever it is that gets under people's collars, I want that, and I want to celebrate it. I want to let the world know that I believe violent video games are important.
Man, should we start playing some like dun, 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 dun,
dun, dun, dun. And I want people to know.
Yeah. Kevin, can you lower an American flag onto the screen for a second?
I have a lot to say about violent video games and just, you know, in general. Game Grumps too, man. Like I just have a lot to say, man. What finally got this to happen expeditiously, my arrival here. Mm-hmm. Was your guys performing? I use the term performing loosely.
Yeah, true that.
Not to put it down or anything, but you guys are in comedy clubs with incredible success. I mean, I showed up. The Hollywood Improv is a fucking legendary comedy club here in Hollywood, California, and they don't always do this, but they sometimes divide it into two different areas. They make the front bar room, like a showroom, much smaller one.
Right.
And I was there just practicing some new material for my tour. And you guys, I saw in the main room, sold out two nights in a row with people in the parking lot, like literally crying that they couldn't get in.
Oh, man.
Yeah, that's crazy.
I mean, I had no idea about
that. Maybe not like crying, but like very, very upset that they couldn't get in. Like, I think actually crying. And now the people.
Are you sure they weren't there for you, though?
No.
I can't get in the Steve-O show.
But the best thing about it is that I think between you guys, because like I said, I perform in comedy clubs as well, and between me and you, you know, like all of us not known for performing stand-up comedy, which is what is sort of expected from performers in comedy clubs, the purest, you know, stand-up comedy people, like, we are just giving them aneurysms. Like, when I was in there, I mean, like, from the stage, people, like, these comedians that I was working with that night, from the stage, they were saying, like, I don't know what's going on next door, but they're these guys playing fucking video games.
Yeah.
they're just playing fucking video games. You could just see that it was driving them crazy.
Yeah. Like,
now, I think that video games is pretty funny. Like, as insofar as I've always considered it pretty much a full-on waste of time, you know?
We totally agree.
I felt that if I was going to invest the time and effort, because it does take considerable time and effort to become proficient, and get good at video games. And I just thought, man, like, who's ever gotten laid because they could finish a video game? Has that ever happened, like, one time? Did anybody ever actually park in the pink zone?
Bro.
Because they were able has it ever happened, you know? Has anybody ever put points on the board because they could play a video game? And I just can't imagine that that's true. And I always felt like if I'm going to put time and effort into something, I want it to be something that can help me get laid. You know? So, like, you know, learn how to juggle. I don't know. Like,
yeah.
Shit that's impressive.
God, no one gets tail like jugglers, man.
Dude, have you been to Venice Beach? Those guys are just swimming in puss.
Oh, my God. That's so good.
I'm
sorry for cutting you off there.
No, that was terribly rude.
I was on an airplane recently. And I was going through their little on-demand library of, because it's an international flight. And I'm going to be on the fucking plane for like 10 hours.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, I figured I'd take a nap and watch some documentary shit on demand. And I went through it. I found a documentary called, the title, are video games really that bad? And I was fascinated by this. So I watched this documentary, and they essentially broke it down into two categories that they were going to address. One being video game violence, and like how every time there's a school shooting or like, you know, any kind of general sort of violence, the first thing that they want to do, like politicians and I guess a lot of other people as well, the media in general, they want to just fucking put video games on trial, and they want to, you know, blame every school shooting, every like act of violence, whatever bad thing that happens in the world, they want to just pin it on video games.
Right, and music and art and stuff like that, yeah.
Right, but I think music is kind of off the hook since video games sort of, you know, became what they are. And it was just fascinating because they had all these experts, all these scientists saying, God, this video game.
Right off the bat. Holy shit.
Yeah.
It gets much better.
That just looks really good to me. Now, all these experts, these scientists and stuff, they're saying that, like, man, they got it all wrong. You know, like every study that they've shown, and the media really irresponsibly leaves out these findings.
Yeah.
That like irrefutably, they have like 100% proven that video game violence absolutely does not lead to real video game or real violence
yeah.
in the real world. It just doesn't. There is no link.
Right.
And every time that there's some kind of act of violence and the media goes and puts video games, tries to blame them, they're just being irresponsible because there is no link there. Now, what there is a link, though, to, and this was fascinating in this documentary, they had the old school game Tetris.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And then they created a different, like, they fucked with it so that they had, like, two versions of Tetris. Like, one was normal Tetris and the other version was just like fucking frustrating Tetris, you know, like where it just, whatever shape you needed to like sort of squeeze in, it would just like 80% of the time make sure you did not get what little fucking shape block that you need
right.
in order to...
That is cruel.
Yeah. It's just cruel, yeah. And so, like, they were able to... And there's nothing violent about Tetris. There's just absolutely nothing violent about that. But what they found was that definitely... Like, the frustrating version of Tetris, you know, Dick Tetris, actually made people...
More violent.
More prone to being yeah. fucking violent. So, like, the link there is frustration, you know?
Yeah.
So as long as, like... I don't know. I'm just... Yes.
Oh, my God.
I'm feeling more violent by the second.
Jeez.
So then the documentary moved on to one other thing. They were talking about the addiction. It was basically just violence and addiction.
Right.
So looking at video game addiction. And I came up with a joke that I want to start doing like a little bit of like a little like comedy bit about video games. Because this I was talking to the comedian that night at the Hollywood Improv. And while the... scientists have proven there is no link between video game violence and real world violence.
Right.
They have found a link between playing a lot of video games and being a complete fucking loser.
Guilty.
Yeah.
Guilty.
You found us, dude.
That's my joke I came up with. That's my first video game joke.
Mazel tov. Congratulations. Congratulations. Yeah, it's weird. I don't know, man. Like, I don't know much about it, but, like, I think probably like social problems and stuff like that have really complicated answers, and it's people just want to look for a simple answer and something that helps them feel like in control a little bit. Like, I think it's a scary, and I mean, listen, I don't know. I'm not an expert or anything.
Well, I can say that I'm kind of an expert on addiction, and I love what you just said. I agree 100% that, right. that people want simple answers, and it's all, you know, super complicated. What the documentary said, they just took this this woman who they used as an example. They really like sort of introduced you to her. They said that she plays on average, like without fail, a good 20 hours
right.
of video games every week. And the scientists that evaluated her determined that she was not in fact addicted.
Mm-hmm.
you know, I could question whether it's addiction is the issue or just like if she has a life, you know, or
yeah,
or
you know. Just you do what you like a lot.
Right, right. Yeah, so, I mean, I really don't care, but I have always maintained that if I did have kids of my own, that I would probably rather they smoke pot than play video games.
Is that right? Yeah.
I mean, but then again, now I'm like a sober guy.
They might do both, Steve. I don't think they're
one usually comes after the other.
Totally.
What, video games second?
Oh, man. They any order, any order.
Yeah, whatever you like.
I mean, I love you guys. This is great.
Well, it's true, man. Like, and I think, honestly, just, I think it's scary to people that, like, that they don't know why violence happens. Or that even, you know, violence goes back way before video games.
I want to make a plug for violence, okay?
Oh,
like,
sure.
The real reason why I wanted to be here, and by the way, like, to all the Game Grumps Nation, you know, like, around the world.
We call them the lovelies.
Yeah.
They're fucking...
Can that be our branding now?
Mm-hmm. Because I think a lot of people watching this will have heard that I have a Game Grumps sticker on my suitcase, and from when I posted a picture of my suitcase at the airport one time, like, the entire comment section of that fucking Instagram post was just Game Grumps, oh my god, you gotta be on here. I hear it all the time, so
awesome.
I just like the rabid support that you guys have and all the encouragement for me to be here has been overwhelming, and I'm really grateful for that.
Oh, thanks for coming, man. Like, we're moved by it too. Like, we don't sometimes. Aaron and I forget that, like, you know, you can feel it. We're just sitting in here on a couch playing games.
Fuck,
and like,
yeah.
You forget, like, the reach it has and what it means to people. And that's why, like, the live shows have been really cool, because it, like, it kind of reminds us that, like, oh, yeah, this is having an effect, and people enjoy it.
Oh, my God, it's crazy, too.
It makes us enjoy it more.
And you guys, like, you know, are like, seriously selling out, man. Like, selling out.
Yeah.
Which selling out are we talking about? Because I don't know whether to be flattered or insulted.
That reminds me, Steve, like, I enjoy the delicious taste of Dr. Pepper as much as the next guy.
But let's stay on topic here.
Right. Now, so on the topic of violence, which is like the reason I wanted to come and I'm so happy to be here is because I just had my first comedy special.
Oh, dude, congrats.
Premiere. It played on Showtime. And for those people who don't have Showtime, like, there's been some eager anticipation for its arrival on Vimeo, which has happened. And right now, you can go on Vimeo and search Steve-O, Guilty as Charged, and find my comedy special, which just happens to be the most fucking violent comedy special ever taped, ever in the history of the world.
Do you kill a guy? Yeah.
No, I come out like violently fucking smashing cans on my head.
Jesus,
like,
fucking game. I'm sorry. I love it, dude. My God, please.
Is this something that we can expect to see in your show?
Yeah.
Sneaking a signpost through.
Impaling someone's head.
No, but what you can expect is that after my violent entrance, from when I take the mic and start, you know, like, doing my fucking act, within 3 minutes, I got a UFC fighter not only choking me completely unconscious, like, but he lifts me up into the air, like, my feet off the ground. He lifts me in the air by my neck and chokes my neck until I'm absolutely unconscious and twitching, and then drops me from all the way up there.
Jesus Christ.
Straight on my head. My head bounces on the stage like a fucking basketball. It's so awesome. And I did that at the fucking top. That was at the beginning of my show. And then I wake up, I'm like, whoa, where am I? You know, I don't know what's going on.
Yeah, maybe I should have saved that for the end.
A lot of people would have said that for the end, man.
Yeah.
But I said, fuck it, man. And you know, like, with it all said and done, I did 2 shows that night. I could not be more fucking thrilled with how it went. Like, you know, like, I was, like, it's upsetting, it's shocking, it's fucking violent, and it is on Vimeo.
Dude, congrats. Everybody needs to watch.
Top it all off, it's on Vimeo.
Right. It'll be on iTunes and maybe Netflix and all that other shit later. And if you have Showtime, it's been on there.
That's awesome, man. That's got to be a great feeling.
Yeah, dude, it fucking, yeah, you know, and like just like you guys, man, I the world of stand-up comedians is not entirely thrilled with my presence.
Well, when you're a boat rocker in any field, I feel like people feel threatened, you know?
Yeah.
Sure, man. Like, yeah, it's great, man. And the thing is, like, I really do, like, you know, I mean, I'm more of a storyteller. Like, you know, it's more of a one-man show kind of storytelling thing with me, but at the same time, it's super stand-up comedy, and the idea is to keep people laughing the whole time, which I've done a pretty good job of, and I definitely pulled it off on the special.
That's awesome, man. I wanted to ask you, like, because I grew up a Jackass fan, like, almost everybody, you know?
Yeah.
Everybody who could stomach it, you know? Like, do you guys ever look back at stuff you did, and you're just like, what the fuck were we thinking? Like, that was really dangerous.
Not at all, man. Like, people ask me all the time, like, do I regret any stunts on Jackass? And, like, you know, like, truthfully, like, the one regret that I have is that I didn't fucking dig deeper and fucking, like, commit more and, like,
oh my
be
God.
Crazier. Like, 'cause there were so many fucking things where, like, we set it up, we're starting to film, and, like, just the bar was so high for what would make it on the show or in the movies.
Right.
And like, you know, and there was just shit that fucking, you know, if I just would have, like, committed more and been crazier and just went more all out, then I would have had more screen time. But there were certain instances where I just straight up half-assed shit, you know?
Oh, my God.
And, like, and it's just like, because I'm scared, you know? Like,
wait, so
like,
would you say that you were...
I would be fucking scared. Like, there was like a time when I was supposed to, like, unicycle along this, like, balance beam. It was like kind of a gymnastics balance beam.
Right.
And I suck at unicycling. And and underneath the balance beam was hot coals, you know? And so I'm supposed to try to unicycle along the balance beam. And, of course, I'm going to fall and I'm going to rack myself on the balance beam, and then I'm gonna fall on the hot coals, and I just fucking wimped out, man, and that fucking plagued me forever. And then we finally got redemption on the flaming gauntlet.
But
it would have been way cooler it would have been way cooler.
Didn't you run through a pit of alligators with meat in your Speedos?
Yeah, uh-huh.
I don't. Your right. version of wimping out and my version.
I'm starting to think that this game choice was not violent enough.
Yeah, yeah. Two very different
you're
things.
You're probably like, oh, whatever.
Can I try? I mean,
yeah,
I go.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Go for it.
I don't have, like... I honestly really, and I hope I haven't offended the video game community too much, man.
There's
hopefully
a couple,
everybody's got a good sense of humor
about
it.
A is punching.
Oh, yeah?
So you run up to people and just hit A.
Yes! Dude, that's me! I'm just randomly fucking pushing buttons, and I'm crushing! Take
crushing
that!
Crushing it, dude!
Yeah. Welcome to our life of accidental success.
Yeah, oh my God.
I should jump a little less,
We're the kings of accidental success.
Yeah, no doubt.
So if you just like, ram A, the A button on your right hand...
Steve!
You'll punch some dudes.
Okay.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah!
You can hold A, then you'll do, like, a finisher.
It's boom!
This has a real Sin City kind of vibe to it.
Uh-oh!
There you go. Now swipe it down. Swipe the controller down. Just like actually with your
hand. Okay. Yeah. Yes!
Hey.
Yes! That was so satisfying! Nice!
What's this game called? What's it for?
Dude, you might convert me fucking yet.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Give up your life.
Dude, I'm just doing a little boogie right there. Like, yeah, I fucked those motherfuckers up.
Yeah.
Just a little, yeah, you did.
That is weird that your default stance is like a gentle ass shake.
Oh, baby. Come on.
All right, dude. I'm so satisfied with that.
Yeah, back to... Yeah, you chainsawed a guy in the head. Your work here is done.
My work here is done.
It was... For me, it was the fucking wasabi snooters where I was I could never, like, just get near that shit. What can you describe the feeling?
Well, I mean, I would do better to describe the general, like, sort of,
Whoa.
A place that I was at in my life at that point. Like, I had no love for my nose or my nostrils or, like, or my nasal cavity or my sinuses. I was in the habit of routinely stuffing that shit full of drugs.
Right.
Specifically cocaine and ketamine. I guess that was all I would really snort. I would snort meth sometimes, like,
God damn, you snorted meth?
Sure, man. Like, wow. I never really got into meth, I also never turned it down.
Jeez, man.
So, I mean, whatever, dude. Like, coke, meth, ketamine, like, Mostly I would just snort cocaine, and I would do it for like 3 days in a row, and then I would sleep for like one day,
God damn.
I would like, that was my routine. And so my nose kind of didn't give a fuck at that point.
Right,
you know?
Right.
But that's because you're sort of like the barf guy in Jackass.
Right. I'm not even sort of. I think that I should have a fucking Guinness Book of World Records. I should have the world record for the guy who barfed on television and you know on the movie screen. More than anybody, because nobody can fucking touch me. I'm professionally bulimic.
Wow. Wow. This is disgusting.
That was so thrilling.
Wow. You know.
Do they have video games, or are they just like straight porn too? Like.
In Japan.
Because yeah, that chick, I kind of just wanted to see her tits just then.
Well, I mean. Video games have gotten to the point now where, like, you'll just see that in, like, a Call of Duty game.
Yeah, there's something called jiggle physics.
yeah.
So do they have, like, age ratings for video games?
Yes,
they do.
Definitely.
Is this, like, considered R?
M is the video game.
It started, there was this game in the early 90s called Night Trap that we played on the show one time, and that got that, like... I mean, it's super tame when you watch it now, but like at the time, it was pretty controversial, and it got that's disgusting. And it got like basically this governmental panel created. What is it? ESRB?
Yeah, the ESRB.
Yeah, and they
Night Trap was the start of that.
Night Trap, yeah, Night Trap and another game, maybe Mortal Kombat, like the two combined.
Definitely, like Mortal Kombat started that whole thing.
Yeah. But it was those two. Because it was like that scene where the girl is like in a nightgown in the bathroom and the dude comes out of the shower and attacks her. Like, that was unheard of at the time.
This kind of makes me want to be violent.
Oh, wow. There you go. But you're not playing it. You're just watching it.
Right.
So,
it's like when you see a movie where somebody's like beating people up. You're like, I want to get into a fight right now.
Dude, I heard those fucking scientists say that there's no link and yet... I'm tickled by all this violence, and like I want to participate.
That's crazy. Have you been in like fights before and like?
Dude, not even, man.
Really?
Like, I've done like some pretty horrific stuff, but fighting is not. There were a few times where we like got in rings, like, we put on gloves and like boxed or whatever. You know?
Yeah.
And the experience I had was that if I don't get you in the first 15 seconds, then I just lose to myself. You know, like I just like my stamina just fucking kaputs.
Right. Yeah, I feel you.
Who got knocked out by Butterbean?
That was Knoxville.
That was not okay. Yeah.
Yeah. Classic line when he wakes up: "Is Butterbean okay?"
I mean, dude, Aaron, do you know what we're talking about?
No.
Butterbean is like this really.
Yeah,
he's like the fattest, most solid boxer in the world.
Right, I don't even think he's necessarily like a real boxer. He's more like who's the one guy? Like he went to the UFC. Why can't I think of his name? Like he's like a backyard fighting sensation. Kimbo Slice.
Oh yeah.
Oh,
I think I almost classify Butterbean as like sort of a Kimbo Slice kind of a guy.
Yeah, that makes
like,
sense.
Like I mean, Ultimate Fighting, but just sort of like, you know. In any case, like a genuinely worth fearing individual, and Knoxville took him on, and not only just a boxing fight, but it hosted it at like a flea market or some kind of a like a.
Oh yeah, they were like in a mall.
They were
something.
In some kind of a fucking shitty flea market mall.
It was weird.
And they just did this impromptu fight, and so it wasn't a ring. And when Knoxville got knocked out, as he fell, like his head, like really hit some shit pretty hard him out. Kind of like my head hit that stage in the fucking the comedy special. I feel bad too because the UFC fighters catching all kinds of fucking problems. Like people are saying, how'd you choke him unconscious and then drop him from all that high up in the air? Ooh. And the answer is simple. I fucking asked him.
You asked him,
yeah.
Just honoring
a request. I wanted the most violent fucking choke out and fucking drop to my head possible.
That's crazy.
And that's exactly what I got. Now they're giving this guy a fucking hard time, and he's the best. he's the best dude ever. Like I love Tim Kennedy. I think he should be he's ranked number 6 in the world in the UFC.
Jesus Christ.
Have you ever gone to like a doctor or something and then like told them or like they're familiar with what you're doing?
Oh my God, dude,
and they're just like, you should not do that.
Dude, this like this fucking concussion movie, like all kidding aside, and I did ask to get dropped on my head, like I've hit my head so much, man, and like this concussion movie and like all the talk about the NFL football players
and
stuff.
Yeah, CTE and stuff like that.
CTE, yeah. What is it like? Or whatever, concussion trauma experience or something.
Encephaly. I don't know. that just makes it sound like a cool indie band. But like, no, the idea is, I think the idea is that like the more concussions you have, the more this chemical gets created in your brain, and it can cause dementia and like. But they don't know if that's true.
And that's
or not.
The thing is that I always figured like I got hit in the head, but I'm okay now.
Right.
And like, cause I mean that thing where I'd smash the cans on my head, like I could smash a fucking soda can or a beer can on my head, like so hard that when it breaks, it goes clean into two pieces.
Jesus Christ.
That's that happened. That happened on my fucking comedy special. I pulled it off like two pieces.
Well, all right.
And
isn't that awesome when you're like filming something and something goes so right?
Oh, dude, everything went right. Yes. Dude, everything went right for me on my comedy special. I was so psyched. And yeah, and I fucking busted up a whole six pack on my head, and wow. I used to do that like every show,
like
you know?
Full of liquid,
yeah, like unopened, yeah.
Wow.
Unopened. Just fucking, if you just hit yourself hard enough and enough times, it fucking blasts. And
noted.
And I would do that, and then like you know, every night I would do it, and then in the morning when I wake up, I get out of bed and I start walking like kind of fucking diagonal, like sideways and shit, and I'm like, whoa, dude, like I'm like. Like vertigo or whatever, like, you know, like my balance is off, and I'm like, dude, that just can't be good for me. I know it's because I'm hitting my head.
Right.
And then there's been times where I hit my head, and like just straight hit my head caused me to black out, you know? So I know that's a concussion, and that's happened a bunch, and like, I don't know, man. I've just fucking hit my head too much.
Oh,
and like,
Steve.
And so then now, the CTE shit, it turns out that whatever the consequences are, like the from all this head trauma, it's not like, oh, I'm okay now, so I know I'm okay. It's actually like 10 years, 20 years down the road is when I'm gonna pay the piper for what's already happened. And I wonder how much other shit like is like that, you know? Like
with the drug use and stuff like that?
Drugs, I just think there was some other example of something like, you know, I can't remember what it is. Probably something terrible, but yeah, I mean, whatever, man.
I hope you're okay, man.
But you know what? Like, the thing is, man, like, our lives as human beings are finite.
Right.
And yeah. But our legacy is forever.
That's true, man.
And right.
That's kind of what was going through my head the whole time that you were explaining that. I was like, yeah, but like, look at what you've accomplished, like
right.
The things that you've done that are like so awesome.
And well, I appreciate that, man. And whatever fucking happens, man. Like, I like to think. I mean, I don't know. That's such old thinking. Like, it used to be my philosophy that like, whatever. I'm not gonna live very long, but I'm gonna live forever.
Right.
You know,
right.
And like, and, you know, and then. I don't know, man. Like, all I ever cared about was, like, I want to be important. I want to be famous. I want to be remembered.
Yeah.
And now I kind of think about it a little differently. It's like, you know, I'd kind of like to just be happy.
Yeah.
Oh, for sure.
Well, sure, because, like, underneath the desire for all that stuff, like the wealth and the fame, it's just you want to be loved and you want to be
It's exactly
happy.
Right,
yep.
Man.
Yep. It like, disguises itself as that other stuff.
That's exactly fucking right. Man, you've said some really... beautiful stuff, man.
Thanks. We get weirdly deep on a show about video games.
Of course, before we started recording, you said some terrible things.
We were exclusively racist before we started the show.
Yeah. From the moment the cameras are off, we are total douche.
I will say that was hyperbole and entirely false. But terrible things were said.
Sometimes terrible things are funny. And like, because we
at point in case.
Yeah. I mean, like, that's the thing.
God,
it's hilarious.
Bless this fucking game.
It's a very fine line you have to walk.
I want to Snapchat like a particularly violent.
Oh, while this is happening.
Yeah. Is that okay?
Yeah. I mean, sure. Dude, we've never had it happen that someone has done social media shit during an episode.
While we're filming. Yeah.
Yeah. But you know what?
Is this guy laced in bombs?
Okay. Oh, that's not good.
Here's what I want. Man, my phone's blowing up like a motherfucker right now.
That's awesome.
I think it's the controversy around the MMA situation.
Oh, I like to think it's the grump bump.
Okay, here. All right.
Yeah, let me find some guys.
Yeah, and... just get violent as fuck.
Okay. Well, the Snapchat gonna... oh, well, there you go. Cutscene.
Oh, nice.
Oh, here we go. Here's some violence.
Okay.
Got a dude with a double chainsaw.
And I'd say go for big bull.
Okay.
All right. This is.
I have a feeling that the violence is going to be on me in a sec.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's wait until you find Big Bull.
Yeah. Where is he? Where's Big Bull?
All right. Yeah.
Oh, there he is. Wait, okay. No, that's not him.
God damn it.
Yeah. Where the fuck?
Why
is
would they give him a cutscene and then not have him show up?
Big Bull's got to be right here. Oh, there he is.
Oh, there he is. Yeah, he's big.
Take him.
Okay. I don't want to see some violence, man.
Oh Jesus. Oh
well, I mean. God damn it,
right
Aaron.
When you ask for it, you can't get it. Well, let's do some classic violence right here.
Okay,
let's bring him over here.
There you go. And a gentle placement.
Throw him on the spikes.
Yes.
Yeah, there we go.
That's what I'm talking about.
Thank God for this.
And the Snapchat has been recorded. Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, we fucking did it. We did it. That will be available.
There's something to be said for vicariousness, right? Because it's like... I feel like if you have like some kind of violent tendency, you like you can enjoy this and be like, ah,
well,
that satiates me.
I mean, there's that argument too, like with like video game versus real violence. Like if you're being violent on video games, then you have an outlet and you're indoors playing video games. Yeah. You're not out being violent.
Exactly.
But I don't know. I don't know.
Yeah, who knows? I feel like everybody's different enough for like those kind of generalities to be sort of not accurate.
Yeah,
in certain cases,
it's totally true. God, there was another jackass thing that I wanted to ask you, but I can't remember what it was now. Oh, first of all, Aaron, with Butterbean, to describe him, he's like if King Hippo was a real person. That's it. And he clocks Johnny Knoxville.
Wow.
And he's also the sweetest guy ever. I don't know who King Hippo is.
King Hippo is from Punch-Out. He's just like a giant... he looks like Butterbean.
That's my favorite, like...
Yeah, for you, Aaron, he looks like King Hippo. For you, Steve-O, he looks like Butterbean.
Yeah, that's what it is.
For the fucking Snapchat, like... Oh, well, let's just do what's easy. We'll just go with some classic, most violent shit ever.
Yeah, no problem. No problem. But it was weird because you could see like real concern on his face after he knocked him out. He was like, "Oh, dude, are you all
right?" Right.
And that's the that always surprises me about UFC stuff too.
Mm.
Like when they clock a guy and the crowd's going crazy and like they jump up on the fence and they're like, "Yeah, I fucking." Probably killed him. And then, and then they walk over to the guy. He's like, "You all right?" And then they hug it out. And I'm like, "God, I'm just not a fighter. I do not understand like the fighting rules."
Well, have you ever seen like Bully Beatdown?
No.
Really?
What's that?
Oh, I gotta show you some of that. Have you seen Bully Beatdown?
Nice.
Boom!
Steve-O's checking out his Snapchat.
Sick Snapchat.
And is pleased with the results.
Bully Beatdown is a show where...
Boom!
I'm glad you recorded it so you can enjoy it for the rest of your days.
Yeah, you can live it over and
over. Oh, dude. So you're just decorating the wall, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, you're gonna go grab another guy and stick him on the wall, too?
Oh, sure, I can do that.
Oh, dude, that's another Snapchat.
I was giving you a lot of social media ammunition, my friend. Happy to do it.
Yeah, look at all of them.
Oh, yeah.
It's like Christmas over here.
Are you prepared?
Right.
Steve-O has the phone out.
Yep.
This is going to happen. The lady of his choice.
We're just decorating the wall. Boom! Look at let's see how many people we put up there.
Well, right now we've got...
dude, come on, man. Let's see.
Let's see. That's like five of them right now?
Yeah.
You know what? We need to do that again.
You hit the whole wall.
You're doing a lot of solid work. We might have to edit this part out.
Yeah, don't even worry about it. Okay. All right, here we go. Okay,
just throw them right on there. Yeah, there we go. Oh, two for one.
So
two for one.
Body. Oh, dude. Kill him.
Yeah, come here.
Kill him.
Come here, baby.
Oh, dude.
I'm going to throw
We are running out of spikes, man.
I'm going to get the... Oh, it's leaving. Oh, it's leaving.
Train's leaving the station.
Oh, it got its delivery.
That's going to be awkward at the next subway stop.
Yeah. Dude, I don't know if I want to ride this train.
Yeah. Jack versus Little Eddie.
To go back to what I was saying before, though,
yes,
the show Bully Beatdown is amazing. It was on MTV, and it was about, like, they would get kids who are bullied onto the show to bring their bully in, and then they would train the bully to fight a real MMA fighter.
Oh.
And they would always get the absolute shit kicked out of them.
How did that not turn into a lawsuit?
Because they signed up for it.
Oh, yeah. Man. Uh-huh. Yeah, I guess so.
And it was insane. Like, half of them would puke, like, just from getting decked in the stomach once.
Oh my god.
It's beautiful.
And then the host of that show,
Mayhem Miller,
has just tragically, it's just one tragedy after another with that guy.
Really?
From the sounds of it, yeah, just trouble with the law, domestic violence, not quite at the level of that War Machine character. Fuck that guy big time. But, dude, Mayhem Miller's been in a tough place, man. I don't know what's going on. Yeah.
I always was a huge fan.
Yeah, I'm a huge fan of him too, and a friend as well, man. I really like that guy.
Yeah, and honestly, like, that show probably, like, those kids probably stopped being bullies, you know?
Well, you know, they have, like, a moment at the end. I mean, there are episodes where, like, Mayhem gets, like, a little real, and he's like, you should not be doing this, this is not cool. And then they're like, oh, okay, like, this, like, MMA fighter who could just, like, clock me in one hit.
Yeah.
Like, there was one episode where Mayhem actually fought, and he took him out in one hit. It was just, like, done.
Mayhem took the other guy out?
Yeah, it was amazing.
Yeah. These guys are just made of different stuff.
Bloodbath Challenge?
Oh, yeah, congrats. Yeah, let's do it. Oh, there's a pimp. There's a pimp loose.
Didn't he just get thrown into a jet engine?
I remember this guy.
I think he's probably going to get thrown into a train in a second.
I'm having a hard time understanding what's going on here. Like, are you in just a shitty world?
Dude, you want me to put the mic so you don't have to hold it?
That's fine.
Because I can bring it in.
I was just zoning out.
I appreciate your honesty.
I want to see your tits.
Oh, man. I think I have to throw these dudes into trains.
Oh, okay. Cool. Oh, is that pimp, like, the host of, like,
yeah,
the show?
Yeah, but then he always dies.
Interesting.
He's like Kenny from South Park.
Right.
Oh, I see.
Okay, gotcha.
So the counts down from five, and then the trains come.
Oh, man. So let me ask you, Steve-O, since you're here, because, like, Aaron and I can fucking talk like idiots anytime. What, like, do you have any, like, when you look at your career, like,
boom.
You've been in entertainment for, like, a long time now.
Yeah, man, fuck, dude, I graduated from Clown College in 1997.
God, is that real?
Yeah.
You did Clown College?
Uh-huh.
That's cool. Is there anything, like, left that you really want to do, like, that you haven't explored yet?
Want to do a rap career?
Dude, I tried that, man. I failed miserably. That was before I got sober. Like, I was on drugs so bad, and I was like, I'm going to make a comedy gangster rap album. And I got a deal with Universal Records.
Holy shit.
And, but then, like, it just all, I was just too fucked up on drugs for anything to be funny at that time.
Right. What was the impetus to get sober if it's not too personal?
Oh, it's not too personal at all, man. It's also very well documented.
Idiot.
Sorry.
Don't even worry about it. Like, Johnny Knoxville organized an intervention.
Oh, good for him and good for you.
No, you got a problem when that's your intervention.
When Johnny Knoxville intervened. He's like, dude, you're doing some crazy shit.
Yeah.
Ooh, like, you're
too
gonna
crazy
die.
For me. Yeah.
I was going to die, dude.
Yeah, wow. And
that was what everybody said, you know. I think it's probable that I would fucking... I could have died, man, big time, man.
Sure, and how long ago was that?
Man, I've been sober for 8 years.
No shit, that's awesome. Dude. Congratulations.
My intervention was March 9th of 2008.
Wow. And like...
So my sobriety date, you count your sobriety date, is the first day that you didn't get loaded.
Okay.
So my sobriety date is March 10th. So I just celebrated 8 years on March 10th.
That's
like
a
last month.
That's a fucking huge triumph, man.
Yeah, thanks, man.
Is it still sort of like an everyday struggle, or...
I mean, life's a fucking struggle, you know?
Sure.
Like, my struggle doesn't really have to do with drugs and alcohol so much anymore, you know? It's just like, whatever, you know, whatever life throws your way, you know?
Life is the struggle.
I mean, we're not getting any younger, dude. That's the struggle.
Sure.
It's like, fuck, man. Like, what am I going to do with my life, you know? Like... And the struggle for me is, like, how am I going to fucking be in a healthy relationship, dude? In the past, I've been, like, pretty promiscuous, you know, like, just trying to hook up with chicks all the time. And ultimately, like, that hasn't, like, made me happy, you know? And then I swore it off, and I'm like, you know, I'm going to learn how to be in a relationship. And first, I'm going to, like, just have, like, you know... no chicks, and like that doesn't make me happy. And then I've tried to be in relationships, and like it's never been successful. And so I just can't figure out what the fucking deal is. And that's my struggle, is trying to, because I think in order to be happy, I need to be in a fucking healthy relationship.
Think so?
I kind of feel that way, yeah.
I mean, everyone's different. Like, there's no, you know, yeah, like, there's no right or wrong. So
you can just crush.
Yeah. I lead an unusual love lifestyle, but like it's different.
Involving a lot of crushing.
I would neither confirm or deny, but like it's just. You know, it's such a weird thing because, like, you know, you get the entertainment industry in, like, Hollywood and movies.
Oh,
and,
my God, the bodies are piling up.
That is your favorite. That is your favorite. Like, you
should get a spike wall for your house, dude.
Right. Yeah.
You just get, like, a lot of movies and TV and stories telling you, like...
Right, what you should crush.
No, God damn it, Steve. Like, just telling you, like, what is a happy ending? You
know, right. Know? Okay, I get it.
Like, the movie ends when the guy and the girl, like,
right,
are kissing, and then they're sweeping, like, camera. But, like...
My life doesn't have sweeping camera angles at all.
Right, you know what I mean, though. But, like...
Okay, so you're saying that the media is lying to us, and what we really need to be doing is crushing.
No!
Dude, I'm on board with this one.
All I'm saying is that, like, there's a lot to relationships and a lot to, like, love and everything that happened after the credits roll in the movie of your life,
right?
You know, like,
that's true, man.
Is there a movie where act one is that?
Yeah,
they probably do.
Oh, sure.
With the sweeping camera angle, and then it's just like, after that, it's like, could you go to the post office and drop off this letter? Like, whatever, you're always asking me to do shit. So, like, that's the whole movie.
Yeah,
man,
it's crazy.
So, like, how do you do most of your crushing? Like,
Steve-O!
do you like Instagram DMs? I've never crushed on a DM from Instagram.
Never.
Really?
You know what? I've only done one DM on.
Do you believe that?
Well, okay, so I must be the stupidest guy on earth because I don't know what crushing is.
Crushing is sexual relations, Aaron.
Oh.
Yeah.
To crush means to crush puss.
Oh.
I didn't feel like we'd have
sense.
To. Didn't feel like we'd have to, like, give you the dictionary definition, but.
Right, to plug into the meat socket.
Oh, man.
I crush with the best of them. Right, guys? Right, fellows?
Yeah, the only person I've ever had a DM exchange with on Instagram is my buddy Pulp Suicide, who is a suicide girl who reached out to us to say hello, and I was like, oh my God, she'd be awesome in a video. So, because I got a band called Ninja Sex Party, and so we asked her to be in it, and she was, and now I've got a friend out of it. But I've never used it, like, as a hookup tool. I don't know.
She's a suicide girl?
Yeah. She's beautiful.
So now, like, here it is.
What do you mean?
Well, you said it. Now it's going down.
It's not going down. It's not. We're just
everybody
friends.
Everybody knows to reach out to her and say, hey, what's going on?
Please don't make her life hard.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Who is this guy? Is he missing a nose?
It wouldn't make her life hard. She would be totally flattered by that.
Well, maybe.
I think she'd be totally flattered to say, like, wow, you know, like, love has been professed.
I super do. I will say that, like, in general,
we have it on the show all the time.
Yeah, this is fun, actually.
Just make Dan super uncomfortable in every episode.
Yeah, believe me, that's usually Brian's job.
Yeah.
But you picked up the reins beautifully. I do love that suicide girl look, though. Like, a lot of tattoos.
Yeah, you
and,
love,
like,
that suicide girl.
Yeah. No. Oh boy. It's warm in here. Dude, did you just chainsaw that dude in the taint?
I got a little chainsaw taint situation going on.
It happens.
Trying to get him in his Achilles heel. But I don't think the game is that smart.
Yeah, but I don't use Snapchat or anything like that. I don't.
I've never even tried to crush on Snapchat.
Is it like, isn't it the?
So what's your main crushing tool?
Yeah. Teach us the ways,
like,
Steve-O.
I'm only like recently single, and in the past I've always deleted all my Instagram DMs.
Right.
But now I'm actually, like, looking at them. You know.
Hey. Hey.
So, like, there could be some crushing.
There's the potential for crushing.
Yeah. Love can approach your life in many ways.
Or crushage.
Ways. Or crushage. That's not a word. It's not a word, dude.
I made it a word now.
Oh, dude.
It's out there. It's been published.
This guy's right. Disgusting. You are really messing him up.
Yeah, whatever. You can take it.
So it's just black and white and red. That's
yeah.
So genius.
Just to accentuate the violence.
There is a comic. Are you into comics at all?
Nah.
Oh, okay, there was a comic when I was growing up.
No, loser.
Yeah, not at all.
Go on with this dumb story.
Yeah, yeah. I, like, please, say the thing I don't care about. There was a comic book called Grendel when I was younger that's fucking awesome, and they did that, like, all black, white, and red for, like, blood and stuff, and it worked.
Man.
It worked so well, and, like, this game is totally reminding me of it. It's, oh,
right
God.
In the face. Right in the face.
This is a really brutal game.
Man, I want
this is exactly here, what I mean. He asked for it, so
can you pause that real quick, or no, just keep doing what you're doing.
Yeah,
man. I'm about to beat him, so there's probably going to be like a cutscene or something.
For those of you at home, we're going for the final Snapchat.
Yeah,
right here. Also, Steve-O, I love the fact that like your fucking lock screen picture is two kittens holding each other.
Oh yeah, here we go, finish. Yeah,
there you go. Oh,
yeah. Yeah, smack him in the face!
That's... God damn. You don't need to.
Yeah, knock his jaw off.
Well done.
I just smashed his face in with a giant mace.
God, that's horrifying.
And he's still alive.
Is he really? Well,
yeah, it looks like, well, no,
he's probably dead.
That's it for him.
You know what? I feel like this is probably a good point to call this an episode.
I think this is an episode, dude.
I think we fucking did it. Hey, Steve-O, thanks a lot for
joining
coming
us,
on,
man.
Yeah, hell yeah, brother,
this
man.
Is, this is great.
This is awesome, and thank you for coming on and being real and telling us, like, some really fucking personal shit, man.
Yeah,
that's,
seriously.
Hey, dude,
a lot of people wouldn't do that.
Dude, you should see my fucking crazy comedy special, man.
We will.
It's crucial.
It's on Showtime and Vimeo.
Yep, that's
I remember.
Right, everybody.
I listen when people say things.
Yeah, I love that we did this, man.
Oh, I'm so glad. Well, you're welcome anytime.
And I'm easy to find on all the social media, so I'll talk to everybody on there. And fucking A, guys, thank you so much.
Of
thank
course.
You, man.
Yeah, woo!
Next time on Game Grumps, baby!
Next time on Guest Grumps.
Woo!
Yeah, dude.
And he's gone. Steve-O just left.
He's already in the car.
He's already out
we can
here.
Hear the engine starting.